something quick. My mind is numb, my stomach's sick. Broken hearts, hopeless things. I've seen what defiance brings. 'Cause the light of day I've always known is in my heart. I'm not alone. Speak to me and tell me all the things I need to know. I want to hear you now. Can you speak to me? I've opened up your world to free me. I want to hear you now.
Before the ancient Celtic days. Continue to celebrate you. We worship you not only with our mouths and with our hands clapping and feet dancing, but Lord, we even worship you on our instruments tonight. Oh yeah. Glory. anointing fall on me, anointing fall on me. Let the power of the Holy Ghost fall on me, anointing fall on me.
Hallelujah.
Enjoy the presence of the Lord right now. Oh, we love you, Lord. We bless you, Lord. honor and
all power to you.
Holy Father, we worship you. Precious Jesus,
all honor, all glory. back against you, breathe, feel your heartbeat. This love is so deep, it's more than I can stand. I melt in your peace, it's so.
Hallelujah. Glory to the Lord God Almighty, who was, who is, and is to come. Welcome once again to Women of Grace, A Voice in the Wilderness. And we're starting chapter 4 of Kingdom Living from our manuals that are supplied by Harvest Time International Institute. Hallelujah. It's a beautiful day, hallelujah, today. The sun is shining, hallelujah. It's not too hot and it's not too cold. It's just right outside. Glory to God. You know, I was thinking as I was drinking my coffee, standing outside listening to the birds singing unto the Lord, this thought came to my mind. The best part of waking up is with Jesus on your lips. The minute you open your eyes, you just begin to thank the Lord before your feet even hit the ground. Just giving him thanks and giving him glory and giving him honor for blessing you to be in the land of the living again another day. Hallelujah. You know, his mercies are new every morning. He gives us every opportunity, hallelujah, to express his love in the land of the living, hallelujah, to those who don't know him, and even to those who are going through, that we are to lift him up and encourage them to continue to walk in the faith, continue to walk in the way, hallelujah, the way of Christ. We are to be edifiers to the body of Christ, to edify one another, to lift one another up, hallelujah, and to forgive one another of any sins, any wrongdoings that they have committed. This is our job at the body of Christ. We are to bring healing, restoration, and peace to the body of believers. Hallelujah, not be about self. You know, self have to die. Glory to God. This is a beautiful day today. You know, and we're going into this lesson on kingdom living, how to be a citizen of God's kingdom. And it's just a wonderful thing. Let us go into prayer. Father, I thank you for your word, Lord. I thank you on your word for today, O Father. Father, that we are kingdom citizens, O Lord God. And by your grace, O Father, you, Father, allowed us to be in the land of the living again another day. Thank you, Lord, that you are our provider. You are Jehovah Jireh, that you are our provider. Father, that you are our sustainer, and the banner over us is love, O Lord. We thank you, Father, for this word on today, O Lord, that is teaching us how to live in your kingdom, Lord. Father, that is teaching us how the authority that we have in Christ the Messiah, O Lord. We thank you, Yahweh, for all that you've done and yet going to do, O Lord. We thank you, Yahweh, that we are written epistles read by men, O Father. Saturate our hearts today. Write your word upon the tables of our hearts today, O Lord. Illuminate our hearts and our minds, O Lord God. And we thank you, Father. We cover this lesson in the blood of Yeshua. We cover ourselves in the blood of Yeshua. And we thank you, Father. And we bind up the spirit, Father, of the sparrow that would come and steal, try to steal the seed, O Lord. Thank you, Father, for harvesters, O Lord. Thank you, Lord, for the angels that encamped round about us to keep your word, O Father. Thank you for the Holy Spirit that dwells on the inside of us, Lord, that speaks to our heart, that teaches us, O Lord, that leads us and guides us, O Lord God, into all truth. We thank you, Father, in the name of your Son, Yeshua HaMashiach. We pray, amen. Well, if you would, turn your swords to Matthew's chapter 16, and we're going to read verse 19. We are in chapter 4 of Kingdom Living, and the title of this chapter is called Keys to the Kingdom. Our key verse is Matthew's chapter 16. This is our key verse. Hallelujah. And I'm going to read that out of the Amplified Bible because it's so powerful. It says, I will give you the keys, authority of the kingdom of heaven. And whatever you bind, forbid, declare to be improper and unlawful on earth will have already been bound in heaven. And whatever you loose, permit, declare unlawful on earth will have already been loosed in heaven. That is our key verse, Matthew chapter 16, verse 19. Introduction. We have already learned about the existence of the eternal kingdom of God and of the King, Jesus Christ. In this chapter, we will discover how to gain access to the kingdom of God as we study the keys to the kingdom, an appointed kingdom. Before Jesus returned to heaven, he told his disciples in Luke chapter 22, verse 29, he said, And I appoint unto you a kingdom, as my Father had appointed unto me. Jesus also spoke of his church would extend the message of the kingdom throughout the world. He said in Matthew chapter 16, verse 18 through 19, And I say unto thee, that thou art Peter, and upon this rock I will build my church, and the gates of hell shall not prevail against it. And I will give unto thee the keys of the kingdom of heaven. And whatsoever thou shalt bind on earth shall be bound in heaven. And whatsoever thou loose on earth shall be loosed in heaven. When he talks about the gates of hell, he's talking about the physical death of Christ will not hinder the establishment of the church, nor will death overtake the church. Talking about the gates of hell, talking about the death. Hallelujah. In this passage, Jesus revealed that Peter would be one of the spiritual foundational stones of the first church. This meant he would be a vital part of its growth and development. Peter's name actually meant a rock or stone. Jesus then said to himself, Upon this rock I will build my church, indicating that the church would derive its existence from him. He would be the rock upon which the church was built. There would be many other lesser stones like Peter, people like Peter, and these stones will be an important part of the church. But Jesus himself was the cornerstone on which the church structure of the church was to be built. Jesus then made two comments regarding this church. First, he said that the gates of hell shall not prevail against it. This implies that the church would have enemies fighting it, but assured that the enemies would not overcome it. And two, and most important to our study, is that Jesus promised to give the keys to his kingdom to the church. In the natural world, if you possess the keys to a building, it means you have the authority there. The authority Jesus was speaking of in this passage is a spiritual authority. He gave the church spiritual keys to the doors of his kingdom. Jesus said, "I will give them." The power and authority of the church was to flow from Jesus. The use of the word will, future tense, meant that the keys had not yet been given at the time Jesus spoke. This power was released in Acts chapter 2 when the Holy Ghost was given to the believers. In Acts chapter 1, turn your swords there, Acts chapter 1, and we're going to read verse 8. Acts chapter 1, verse 8 reads, and I'm going to read that out the Amplified Bible. It says, "But you will receive an ability when the Holy Spirit comes upon you, and you will be my witnesses to tell people about me, both in Jerusalem and in all Judea and Samaria, and even to the ends of the earth." The keys to the kingdom were the power to bind and loose. To bind something means to put feathers or a bond on it. It is like closing and locking the door to a room. To loose something is to release or set it free. It is similar to opening the door to a room. The church would have a position of authority. It would have the keys to God's kingdom. It would be the instrument through which the spiritual doors to the kingdom would be open to the nations of the world. Peter would be the first to use these keys to the kingdom. He would open the door of the ministry to the Gentile nations of the world. The church would have the power to loose the spiritual forces of good and bind the spiritual forces of evil. In every difficulty, in every difficult faced by believers, binding and loosing would be the key to victory. How to enter the kingdom. Now, the keys to the kingdom were given by Jesus to the church, but specifically, how was entrance to be gained to the kingdom of God? In John chapter 3, verse 1 to 20 to 21, records the story of Nicodemus, a religious leader at the time of Christ's ministry on earth. He came to Jesus desiring to gain access to the kingdom of God, and by doing so, inherit eternal life. Jesus told him in verse 3, "Verily, verily, I say unto thee, except a man be born again, he cannot see the kingdom of God," or he cannot enter the kingdom of God. Nicodemus was confused. He asked Jesus, "How can a man be born when he is old? Can he enter the second time into his mother's womb and be born?" Jesus then goes to explain to Nicodemus that the born-again experience of which he spoke was not a physical birth. Through physical birth, you are born into a kingdom of this world as a citizen of a nation, which is the kingdom of darkness. A natural birth, you inherit the basic sin nature. In Psalms chapter 51, verse 5, David cries out and says, "Behold, I was sharpened in iniquity, and in sin did my mother conceive me." Because God's kingdom is a spiritual kingdom, you must be born into it through spiritual birth. You must change your reticency from the kingdom of Satan to the kingdom of God. Jesus said in John chapter 3, hallelujah, Jesus said in John chapter 3, turn your Bibles there, Give me a minute. Hallelujah. Thank you, Father. Hallelujah. Thank you, Father. Let's go to John chapter 3. Hallelujah. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Lord. Thank you for your word. Hallelujah. I have to turn my computer is acting up with the lesson on it, but I know that we are in John chapter 3. Hallelujah. You know, it's amazing that when you begin to teach about the kingdom of God and about the truth, hallelujah, of Jesus Christ, the Messiah, how hallelujah, how the enemy comes in to distract. Okay, we're in John chapter 3, and we're going to read verses 6 and 7. John chapter 3, verse 6 and 7. Turn your Bibles there. And it reads, "That which is born of the flesh is flesh, and that which is born of the Spirit is spirit. Marvel not that I said unto thee, ye must be born again." We must be born again to enter the kingdom of God. You must identify yourself with Jesus' death, his burial, and his resurrection in order to be a part of God's kingdom. And then you must be baptized in the Holy Ghost, in the Holy Spirit. A new birth must take place. Hallelujah. A new birth must take place. Hallelujah. Here, Paul explained that you could not enter the kingdom with flesh and blood body. You cannot enter the kingdom with flesh or blood. Okay, turn to 1 Corinthians chapter 15, and we're going to read verse 50. 1 Corinthians chapter 15, verse 50. Thank you, Father. Hallelujah. And it reads, "Now this I say, brethren, that flesh and blood cannot inherit the kingdom of God." That flesh and blood cannot inherit the kingdom of God.
Hello?
Yes, Liz, please hold. Hallelujah. My daughter's trying to get, today is my grandson's birthday, and she's getting her things in order for his birthday. But getting back, you cannot enter the kingdom of God with flesh and blood, but it's a spiritual birth. Let me read this out of the Amplified Bible, 1 Corinthians chapter 15, verse 50, and it says, "Now I say this, believers, that flesh and blood cannot inherit nor be a part of the kingdom of God, nor does the perishable mortal inherit the imperishable immortal. You enter the kingdom of God and become heirs of the kingdom through spiritual birth. The way to be born again is by believing that Jesus died to pay for the penalty of your sins. You must confess your sins, ask for forgiveness, and place your trust in Him. In John chapter 3, verse 16 and 17, "For God so loved the world that He gave His only begotten Son, that whosoever believeth in Him should not perish, but have everlasting life. For God sent not His Son into the world to condemn the world, but that the world through Him might be saved." Repentance from sin and having faith toward God is covered in our Harvest Time International Institute course entitled Foundations of Faith, which we will be doing that study later on throughout this year, if God is willing. If you have not received the born again experience, we encourage you to obtain, hallelujah, this course and study a little bit more. It is through Jesus Christ that you can move from the kingdom of Satan to the kingdom of God. In other words, you must change your alliance from the kingdom of Satan to the kingdom of God. In Colossians chapter 1, verse 13, it reads, "God, who had delivered us from the power of darkness and translated us into the kingdom of His dear Son." That's Colossians chapter 1, verse 13. We must change our alliance. Hallelujah. I had spoken in my Roman studies, talked about the new birth, the baptism. When you are baptized, you are identifying yourself with Jesus' death, His burial, and His resurrection, and filled with the Holy Spirit. This is why it's important that you must be born again of water and the Spirit, because the natural man cannot enter into the kingdom of God. Jesus' kingdom is a spiritual kingdom. Hallelujah. And those, the citizens of that kingdom, have to enter in spiritually, that you must be born again. Repentance or revolution. When Jesus came to earth to extend the kingdom of God, some who acknowledged Him as King thought the kingdom would come through revolution. They thought there would be an actual physical revolt against the existing ruling powers of the world. But Jesus taught that the key to His kingdom was not revolution, but repentance. In John chapter 18, verse 36, it reads, "Jesus answered, My kingdom is not of this world. If My kingdom were of this world, then would My servants fight that I should not be delivered to the Jews. But now is My kingdom not from hence." He clearly states that His kingdom is not of this world. Let's go on. Mark chapter 1, verse 14 and 15 says, "Now after that John was put in prison, Jesus came into Galilee preaching the gospel of the kingdom of God, and saying, This time is fulfilled, and the kingdom of God is at hand. Repent ye and believe the gospel." Also in Mark chapter 4, verse 17, he goes on to say, "From that time Jesus began to preach and say, Repent, for the kingdom of heaven is at hand." When Jesus died on the cross, two thieves were crucified on crosses near Him. One of them repented and asked, in Luke chapter 23, verse 42 and 43, it reads, "Lord, remember me when Thou comest into Thy kingdom." And Jesus said unto him, "Verily I say unto thee, today shalt thou be with me in paradise." Repentance is the only way to gain access to the kingdom of God. Not going to church on Saturday and Sunday, not working, doing the works of the law, but repentance, having a change of heart, hallelujah, being baptized and filled with the Holy Spirit. In Matthew's chapter 7, verse 13 through 14. Hallelujah. Here Jesus warned that there would be many false doctrines and false prophets claiming they were the way to the kingdom. And it reads, "Enter ye in at the strait gate, for wide is the gate, and broad is the way that leadeth to destruction, and many there be which go in thereat. Because strait is the gate, and narrow is the way which leadeth unto life, and few there be that find it." There is only one way to enter the kingdom, and that is through Jesus Christ. Jesus warned that you should enter the gate to eternal life, because someday the entrance will be shut. In Luke chapter 13, verse 24 to 25, it reads, "Strive to enter in at the strait gate, for many, I say unto you, will seek to enter in and shall not be able. When once the master of the house is risen up and has shut the door, and ye begin to stand without and to knock at the door, saying, Lord, Lord, open unto us. And he shall answer and say unto you, I know not whence you are. Now is the time, beloved. Now is the time of repentance. Now is the time of favor with God, to believe on the Lord Jesus Christ, Yeshua HaMashiach, as your Lord and Savior. To repent, meaning have a change of mind, a change of heart towards God, turning back to God, confessing your sins, receiving Christ as your Lord and Savior. Now is the time before the door shuts, before the door closes. Now the door to the kingdom is open for all, and we can enter it by repenting from sin. In the time of God's judgment of the world, it will be too late. When the king returns for his bride, it will be too late, beloved, for you to enter into the door. The door will be closed. Three parables about entrance. Jesus told a series of parables in Luke chapter 15, verse 1 through 32. Luke chapter 15, verses 1 to 32. And we will learn later about these parables in the course. Parables were natural examples Jesus used to illustrate spiritual truths. And in Luke chapter 15, he talks about lost sheep, a lost coin, and a lost son. They all concern entrance into the kingdom of God. The parable of the sheep seeking the lost sheep, the shepherd seeking the lost sheep, illustrates how God seeks to bring those who are spiritually lost into his kingdom. The parable of the woman looking for a lost coin illustrates the diligence with which you should seek for those lost in sin to guide them to the kingdom. And the parable of the lost son illustrates the principle of repentance through which you gain your rightful place as an heir of the kingdom of God. Adding to faith. It is through faith in God and his Son, Jesus Christ, that you entered the kingdom of God. In James chapter 2, verse 5, it reads, "Hearken, my beloved brethren, had not God chosen the poor of this world, rich in faith, and heirs of the kingdom, which he had promised to them that love him?" The Apostle Peter, however, speaks of spiritual qualities. Add to your faith. Hallelujah, virtues. He speaks of spiritual qualities that we should seek to develop in our life after the new birth experience. He says in 2 Peter chapter 1, 5 through 11, let us read, "And besides this, giving all diligence, add to your faith virtue, and to virtue knowledge, and to knowledge temperance, and to temperance, patience, and to patience, godliness, and to godliness, brotherly kindness, and to brotherly kindness, charity. For if these things be in you and abound, they make you that you shall neither be barren or unfruitful in the knowledge of our Lord Jesus Christ. But he that lacketh these things is blind and cannot see afar off, and hath forgotten that he was purged from his old sins. Wherefore, the rather, brethren, give diligence to make your calling and election sure. For if ye do these things, ye shall never fall. For so an entrance shall be ministered unto you abundantly into the everlasting kingdom of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. That was 2 Peter chapter 1, verse 5 through 11. After you enter the kingdom through faith, you must develop a lifestyle consistent with governing principles of the kingdom of God. If you do not do this, you will soon forget God has cleansed you from sin and return to the old lifestyle. Peter says that if you go on to spiritual maturity, your entrance to the kingdom will be assured. Later in this course, we will learn principles for kingdom living, for living in the kingdom of God, which will help you achieve spiritual maturity. Hallelujah. This was a very short chapter. Chapter 4 was a very short chapter. Let's do our self-test. Hallelujah. On a sheet of paper. Test yourself. Hallelujah. Test yourself to see if you are where you're supposed to be. Hallelujah. Write the key verse from memory. And our memory verse is Matthew 16, verse 19. It says, "And I will give unto thee the keys of the kingdom of heaven. And whatsoever thou shalt bind on earth shall be bound in heaven. And whatsoever thou shalt loose on earth shall be loosed in heaven." 2. To whom were the keys of the kingdom giving? Hallelujah. 3. What are the keys to the kingdom? 4. What necessary action must take place in order for one to transfer from the kingdom of Satan to the kingdom of God? 5. What did Jesus tell Nicodemus he must do in order to enter the kingdom of God? Reach St. John chapter 3. What does the passage of 2 Peter verses chapter 1 verse 5 through 11 teach? And you can use your Bible to answer this question. 7. What does it mean to bind something? And what does it mean to loose something? Hallelujah. In our further study, in a previous chapter, we studied an outline of the life and teaching of Jesus organized on the basis of the king, the kingdom, and principles of that kingdom. The outline combined the four gospel records of Matthew, Mark, Luke, and John. Hallelujah. Part one was the genealogy of the king. The introduction, hallelujah, that was in Matthew's. Now we, you will study on your other time, you can study the book of Matthew. Although written for all believers, targeted, this book was targeted to the Jews as its original audience. Matthew presented Jesus as the promised Messiah and stressed the role of Jesus as King of the Jews. Matthew's emphasized the gospel of the kingdom taught by Jesus because of this emphasis. Matthew is one of the most kingdom-oriented books of the Bible. The word kingdom is found more than 50 times in Matthew's record, and he uses the phrase kingdom of heaven throughout the entire book. In Matthew's, hallelujah, chapter 1, 1 through 17, he talks about the genealogy of the king. Hallelujah. And also in Matthew chapter 1, verse 18 to chapter 2, 23, he talks about the birth of the king. In Matthew's chapter 3, verses 1 to chapter 4, verse 11, he talks about the preparation. Hallelujah. In Matthew chapter 4, verse 12 through chapter 13, verse 58, he talks about ministry of the king in Galilee. And it goes on, read the book of Matthew's and notice how the structure, how it is structured. And it's a vital point of the kingdom. Hallelujah. It's a vital point of the kingdom. Hallelujah. Of chapter 4 that we're studying about the kingdom of God. Hallelujah. He goes on to talk about the king's death and his triumph. He talks about the kingdom. He talks about the pretended religious authority. That's in Matthew 23, verse 1 through 3. Hallelujah. He talks about taxes and Caesar. He talks about the resurrection. He talks about the great commandment, which is love. Hallelujah. We have come to the end of chapter 4. And later on this evening, we are going to go into spiritual strategies, chapter 4 of that study. I believe we're on chapter 4, if not chapter 5 of that study. But go over to the lessons, read, hallelujah, read St. John chapter 3 and the book of Matthew's book of Matthew's chapter 1, hallelujah, the book of Matthew's throughout this week. But the main one is the book of Matthew's and John. But beloved, in order to enter into the kingdom of God, in order to become, to inherit the kingdom of God and a citizen of God, you must first repent, confess your sins, and receive Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior. You must be born again. Beloved, it's not you attending church, whether it's on a Saturday or whether it's on a Sunday. It is not you attending church that you enter into the kingdom of God. You must be born again. Hallelujah. You must repent, be baptized in water and the Spirit. Your lifestyle must change. Hallelujah. What will change? Hallelujah. When the Holy Spirit comes and you are baptized in the Holy Spirit, your lifestyle would change. But it just does not stop there. We must continue to seek the face of God. We must continue to read His Word. We must continue to search the Scriptures and allow the Holy Spirit to teach you. It just does not end when you are born again. Our salvation is a continual walk with the Lord until He returns for the bride. Now is the time of salvation, beloved. Now is the kingdom of God up on you. And if the Holy Spirit is speaking to your heart, repent, turn to Jesus before He returns. Because when He returns, He's coming for His bride, and the door will be shut. He will take the Holy Spirit with Him. Hallelujah. All things that belong to Him would go with Him. Hallelujah. You don't want to be left behind. Hallelujah. Because God's judgment is coming. And now is the time for repentance. Now is the time of acceptance. Receive Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior. Enter into the kingdom and be blessed. Hallelujah. Learn of Him. Learn who He is. Walk with Him. God desires a relationship with you. And the only way that you can obtain that relationship with Yahweh, Elohim, is through Jesus Christ. That is the only way, beloved. Hallelujah. Let be not deceived. You going to church, doing good works, doing the law, does not gain you inheritance into the kingdom of God. But repenting of your sins, receiving Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior, being baptized in water and the Spirit, what makes you a citizen of God's kingdom. Well, let us close. Father, I thank You for this word, O Lord. I thank You, Father, that, Father, we must be born again to enter into Your kingdom. And I thank You, Father, that we're learning this principle, Lord God, Father, that is rarely taught within the body of Christ today. Father, help us to understand, Father, that your kingdom is a spiritual kingdom, and we must be born again to be spiritual, O Lord, to enter into your kingdom. Thank you, Father, for this word on today. We thank you, Father. In Yeshua HaMashiach's name we pray, amen. Well, beloved, as we close, hallelujah, as we close, hallelujah, may God bless you. May God bless you. May God keep you. May God's face shine upon you as you continue to seek his face by sitting at his feet and learning of him. Until then, beloved, God bless you and shalom.
This love is so deep.